This video is brought to you by Ridge Wallet. Guys, it's 2020. It's time to organize your life. Start by getting rid of that small suitcase you keep in your back pocket, the Ridge Wallet. It's different. It's sleek, industrial, and fits in your front pocket. It will change your pocket game. Ridge Wallets hold up to 12 cards, plus all the cash that you need. Choose from over 30 colors and style, including carbon fiber and burnt titanium. It is the best wallet you can buy, and you don't have to take my word for it because there's over 30,000 five-star reviews. I was skeptical at first, but once you try it, you'll never go back to your old wallet. There's no pressure. Test it for 45 days. If you don't love it, send it back for a full refund. If you decide to keep it, there's a lifetime warranty. Click the link in the description to get 10% off today with free worldwide shipping and returns. Go to ridge.com/Chael. That's ridge.com/Chael and use the promo code Chael. So as the Sugar Show comes into town, okay, we have to take a look at what's going on here. And there's some guys that you want to study. There really is. And I know every athlete's inclination is whoever has the best kicks, I'm going to go copy those kicks, and whoever's got the best punches and the takedowns, and those are the guys I'm going to study because this is what I'm doing. Look, you're not wrong to do that. This is a sport that is competitive. And what takes place in there, boy, I would never want to give you a message to act as though that's secondary. It's not. To believe that the entertainment aspect, as we live in the entertainment era, and what all I'm doing when I talk to you about entertainment is I'm talking to you about building your army, building your troops, known as fans, known as supporter, but whoever's got the biggest military gets the highest place on the card. That's the way it works. That's all we mean when we're talking about entertainment. So what are you going to do to be entertaining? That doesn't mean you have to go hit the moonwalk or grab a microphone and sing a song. It doesn't mean you can't hit the moonwalk and that you shouldn't grab the microphone and sing a song, okay? I mean, there's a place there for everybody that's creative and unique and different. And there are some guys who understand this differently. Henry Cejudo, who has competed headline for headline with anyone who's gotten a headline since Henry retired. How in the hell is Henry getting equal headlines to the Masvidals and the Usmans and the Stipes and the Cormiers of the world when he's retired? How's he doing it? Well, go and study it. There's an answer there. Izzy Adesanya, who will never leave a building without having his next fight lined up. There's something to study there. Dan Hooker, who will never take a microphone without calling out directly an opponent and laying out his case of who, what, when, why, and where, needs to be studied. So, as Suga Sean is getting ready to go and fight Marlon Vera, okay, Suga Sean has said everybody in the world's name except Marlon Vera. I've literally not heard him say it once. I trust that that is not a literal statement, but I can tell you accurately, I have never heard it. He's talking about Cody Garbrandt. He's talking about Peter Yan. He's taking a page in some ways out of Adesanya's book where I've already got this job, but what's most important is that I have another one. He's using the media tour for this fight to build something different. And in all fairness, if he says Marlon Vera over and over again, there's just not as much traction and not as many headlines, and it's not as captivating as he is to call out Peter Yan or Cody Garbrandt. It's an old carny trick, but it never quits working. It's one that Sean observes and that he's moving forward with. So what do you do if you're Marlon Vera? What do you do when the PR team isn't calling you because people aren't requesting you for media? That's a very mean-sounding thing. Well, this is a very mean business, and that's exactly what's happening. Suga Sean, who is getting given a bully pulpit, is using that for whatever he chooses to do with his career. But if you are not given one back, how do you counterpunch? How do you make yourself relevant? How do you do it? And there are many people that believe, I've got to wait until the media finds me. These are the same people that are out there winning fights and doing everything right and under the guise of, I don't know when that phone's going to ring. You can fall to that and that phone just might ring, or you can go out, win those fights and pick the phone up and say, hey, here's who I am and here's what I'm doing. When can I get on your radar? How about right now? I mean, there's another way to do it. I would argue for you that the media did not choose Conor McGregor. Conor McGregor chose the media. Conor McGregor came out with something that was interesting and captivating and then went out and said, hey, you, bring your microphone over here. It was totally different. So what are you going to do and how are you going to do it? And now if you're in the spot of Marlon Vera, what do you do? If you're confined to what you have access to, which in all fairness, it's a very tough spot. Marlon's done nothing wrong here. He's just been put in a very tough spot. Big opportunity. Gonna have a ton of eyeballs because of his opponent. That's fine. Doesn't need to knock his opponent for that. Go ahead and get whatever shine you can. Sometimes you're the hammer, sometimes you're the nail, as long as you're on the job site, right? I mean, you're a step in the right direction, but if you're stuck with the confines of what's given to you, which is largely social media, what else do you have control of? Social media is huge. It's a good place to start. But what do you do as the week progresses? Don't forget, there are some built-in mechanisms for fighting Sean O'Malley. You are going to have a media day, for sure. Now, how energized is the media going to be and how many questions are you going to get? Well, that's all how you manipulate the system, but it's still going to happen. So now if you're confronted with a media on Thursday, when a weigh-in's on Friday and you fight on Saturday, you're confronted by a media who has ignored you for 2 months. How much do you think you could possibly get done from Thursday to Saturday to try to steer the cart back on horse? There is nothing in this point. I've seen a number of fighters in this spot, and you have too. Like, let's say Marlon Vera goes out and he catches Sean and knocks him out and puts him down. Or doesn't catch him, but does something and puts him down. We're all going to default back to, that didn't happen and you don't matter. Sean's a star. You got lucky. Hey, Sean, when are you fighting next? As opposed to elevating Vera and giving him the tip of the hat. It would work that way in a straight line bracket sport. This was the NCAA championships or the Sweet 16 or even the playoffs for the NFL. It's a straight line bracket and you advance. That's not how this sport works. It's still whoever has the most troops. Whoever has the mandate is going to move forward faster. That's what we're talking about when we say the entertainment era. Look, if I'm Vera and you guys have ignored me for 2 months and now because I'm here and you're obligated to talk to me, guess what I'm going to say? Same thing you've asked me to say for 2 months. You got to steer into problems. It's a rule in politics. It's also a rule that Vince McMahon has. Vince McMahon does not care if you want to be Hacksaw Jim Duggan. If he tells you to grab a 2x4 and hold your thumb up while you're marching to the ring, he expects you to do it fully. No matter how bad the character or how bad the hand you believe you have been dealt, you steer into it and you go into it fully. With a positive attitude, if Vera is being put in a position where he simply doesn't matter, and they've ignored him for two, Vera's a stud, by the way. If you guys have followed Vera, and I do, this is a tough night out, but you still are as you are perceived in life, and particularly within this sport. If you are perceived as an afterthought, as something that's going to happen in the evening, as Suga Sean marches closer to a championship, and as we all get closer on the card itself to the trilogy fight between Stipe and Cormier, if that is how you were perceived, go into it. I don't see any reason that he talked to any of them. I don't see anything that he could say that's going to help to make him interesting. I would imagine, quite fairness, he's probably pissed off. Well, who wants to go out on camera and be the guy that's pissed off? That's how you want to be known, as the angry guy? And there's also a rule, if you're ever explaining, you're losing. So if he comes out and starts defending himself and his plight and his position, then nobody's talked to me and I've won X out of so many fights and I've got this ranking and I've been doing it before Sean's doing it. If you're explaining, you're losing. So what is it you're going to say? What is it you're possibly going to say on Thursday before you weigh in on Friday, before you walk out on Saturday? If you didn't have the sense that God gave geese to go out like Colby Covington did and hire your own camera crews, go out like Kevin Lee did, set up your own press tour. Go out like Henry Cejudo continues to do and make your own headlines. If you did not do those things, and that's, again, I'm not knocking him. I'm talking about the spot that Vera is in. It's a reality. If he wanted to go focus on the fight and nothing else, well, by God, he got his way because there has been nothing else. I would only offer to follow a page of the Hacksaw and the Vince McMahon playbook that you steer into whatever it is you've got. And if everybody's been trying to keep you quiet from day one, there's no point in talking now.